The world's a weird place, and I've seen some very strange things in my life. And one of the things that I've seen is that, you know, I've dealt with some people who were very, let's say, that they weren't on a good path, let's put it that way. And one of the things that was really interesting about being around people like that, it was like almost like they were surrounded by a gravitational field of sorts. I'm speaking metaphorically, obviously. And their worldview was so warped and twisted that if you came within contact of them, you all of a sudden started to play a part in their drama. And it was almost inevitable. They would maneuver and manipulate and interpret in a way that made you into the villain in their story, no matter what it was that you wanted to do. And unless you've encountered something like that, and many of you probably have, you don't know how powerful a pull that is. And so it's certainly possible that someone can act in a like a gravitational object and bend things around them to fit their narrative, their unhappy and tragic narrative. But I've seen the opposite too, you know, where people who were aiming upward with the best of their ability, and because of that, they had a positive effect on the people around them, and that ordered things around them in profound ways. And I think it's an open question, the degree to which the cosmos would order itself around you properly if you got yourself together as much as you could get yourself together. Like, I mean, we know that things can go very, very badly wrong if you do things very badly wrong. There's no doubt about that. But the converse is also true. If you start to sort yourself out properly and then you have a beneficial effect on your family, I mean, first of all, that's going to echo down the generations, but it also spreads out into the community. And we are networked together. You know, we're not associated linearly. We all affect each other. And so it's an open question the degree to which acting out the notion of the notion that being is good and the notion that you can accept its limitations and that you should still strive for virtue, it's an open question how profound effect that would have on the structure of reality if you really chose to act it out. And I've seen things, as I said, in my life that indicate that I do believe there's a metaphysical element to life as well as the rational, practical element. And I think there are times when those two things come together, and I've seen that happen. And so I don't think we know the limits of virtue. I don't think we know what true virtue could bring about if we aimed at it carefully and practically. And so the notion that there's something divine about the individual who accepts the conditions of existence and still strives for the good, I think that that's an idea that's very much worth paying attention to. And I think the fact that people have considered that idea for at least 2,000 years quite seriously is also an indication that there's at least something to be thought about in relationship to that. So that's kind of the Trinitarian idea.